cheese. Cost a quarter piece, give or take. If you drank and throw it all, you don't need none in your car. Hit the block like the Kimbe. Bro got beans like Dende with my eye, Jackie Chan. I go this way, you go.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, New Era Mar. Back again with another video for y'all. Today, we're gonna be reviewing this new J. Cole album, The Off Season. Yes, we're gonna be reviewing it. This will not be a first reaction because I already heard the project like 2-3 times now. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go through each song. We're gonna talk about each song. I'm gonna break it down, give you my opinion on it, how I feel about it. At the end, I'll give it a rating out of 10. We'll go from there. So track number one is 95 South.
I can't believe these fucking clowns. Look how everybody clapping when your 30th song album do a measly 100,000. If I'm betting on myself, then I completely double down.
When I heard this song, I got hyped. I got hyped when I heard this for the first time because I'm like, okay, first of all, first thing you notice, he got Killer Cam. He got Cam'ron on the track. I like that. I'm like, okay, thank God you didn't let Cam'ron rap. I never want to hear Cam'ron rap. That's me personally. Not in 2021. I mean, back in the Dipset era, I'm going to let him get that off. But I do not want to hear that nowadays. Cole came in. I heard the beat. The beat, he used the same sample as Jay-Z did on the Blueprint. You Don't Know. The track You Don't Know. Jay-Z. Same sample. I like that. Like, he just slowed it down a little bit and flipped it his own way. It sounded good. It sounded like that early 2000s Rockefeller Dipset era type of, you know what I mean? Like, the beat was perfect, but he put a little bass in it. A nice little percussion in it that made it. He brought it home. It sounded like a good blend of the early 2000s and 2021 rap and blending them. And he came in flowing on it. He sounded confident. I like how Cole was rapping. I'm like, okay, this is a strong intro. Cam talking over a beat that sounded like something Dipset would have rapped on. It was fire. It was a strong opener. Now I'm hyped. I'm like, okay, here we go. This is the energy we get in the whole album. You got me hooked. Then we get into track number two.
Watch it till you catch it off the bad boy. Feel like nigga never seen nothing. Except a fucking triple beam jumping. Good don't leave a thing crumping. Me and y'all gotta mean something.
I ain't gonna lie. I wasn't really feeling it off my first listen. My first two listens. Honestly, I'm still on the fence about it. I'm not really a big fan of this song. I think it's okay. It's okay, but it don't have that standout. Like, nothing about it really stands out to me. You get what I'm saying? Like, the beat ain't that fire. Track number three is My Life. The first time I listened to the project, he didn't have the features listed on Apple Music. As soon as it came on, the first thing I said was, this sounds eerily familiar. Eerily familiar to something else I heard Cole on. First thing I thought was the song he did with 21 Savage, A Lot. Had the song A Lot come to my mind as soon as I heard this. That's the first song that came to my mind. I said, okay, so this sounds exactly like the sample, the same sample. Maybe it's a different sample, but the sample sounds, it's like the same tempo, everything. So I'm like, this sounds like something I already heard him do before. Why would he do it again? And I made a joke in my head. That's what's crazy. As I was listening to it, I'm like, dang, even when the beat came in, it was like, do, 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 boom, boom, boom. It was just like A Lot. I was like, this sounds like the same. Did the same producer make this? I'm listening. I'm like, it would be hilarious. I said, he's not that predictable. I said, but it would be crazy if he put 21 Savage on this. I would be done. And then in the middle of the verse, all I heard was 21. Yeah, 21. I said, no. Nah, maybe he's using his ad lib. But then sure, lo and behold, 21 Savage come on. I'm like, come on, you got to be kidding me. Y'all already did one like this. Y'all did a song. Y'all did A Lot. It was a hit. It felt like Cole was like, you know what? I want a song as big as that too. I want a hit just like that. So why not redo what we already did? Same method. Why switch it if it's not broken? Really? That's lazy. That was lazy to me. Now, the song is not a bad song. I can't call it a bad song because A Lot is a great song. This song is a good song, too. I like it. It's the same formula. You really couldn't lose with it. Track number four. Where that? applying pressure.
I got my mind on much bigger things, to say the least. My latest speeches sound like they was released by David East. Verses hit hard, never pitched hard to play the streets. These niggas whips hard behind closed doors, can't pay the lease.
Cole killed this song. I ain't gonna lie. Cole killed this joint. And what's crazy is the first time I heard it, I ain't like it like that. And it wasn't because of his rapping at all. I never questioned his bars, his pen game. I never questioned that. It's always the production for me with Cole. And I didn't really like the beat that much at first. But see, the thing is, you got to understand, I messed up the first time I listened to the project because I listened to a bunch of other stuff that dropped the same morning. Like Migos, they dropped their song Straightening. I listened to that for like an hour straight. A couple other artists dropped little songs. I listened to Nicki Minaj. She dropped a song with Drake and Wayne. I listened to that like 100 times. So I want a certain type of vibe. So when I got this album, some of the beats was like, I'm not in the mood for this type of music right now. I want to hear the speakers knocking, like, you know what I mean? That's what I was looking for. That's my fault. I got to understand Cole is not that artist. You know what you're getting when you listen to a Cole project. So the first time I heard it, I wasn't really feeling it that much. And I'm like, he's rapping good, but I don't know. The beat is throwing me off. But after a second, third, fourth listen, this song is hard. It ain't the hardest beat. It's not. But I can deal with it. Especially when I hear how he's flowing over it. I like what he was rapping about. I like the bars. This is him tip-top shape lyrically. Track number five. This right here is my song. This is the first song off of first listen. This was the first song. Well, the first 95 South, the first song, was dope. I thought that was my favorite song up until this point.
Till they cool off, they murdered the nigga right in front of me. Told him to come off his chain for trying to floss. Died over a cross, just like the start of Christianity.
Died over a cross, like the start of Christianity. Good God. This nigga killed this song. Now this, I said the last song was him in tip-top shape. This was him showing you, I can go a little further. You want me to go Super Saiyan with it? This is where he really exercised his lyrics over a beat I enjoyed. I said, okay, this right here, as soon as the beat dropped, I said, damn, I want him to put Kendrick on this. Why would you not put Kendrick on this? This is a Kendrick beat to the fullest. Kendrick has beats like this. He has like two or three songs where I heard beats that sound like this, and he murdered them. This is a Kendrick beat. This song is fire. The beat is fire. Cole's rapping was fire. It was undeniable fire. I didn't have to question it and listen to it 30 times to force myself to get into the vibe. I didn't have to take 30 shots of liquor and then listen to it after I spin three times on my head and I'm blindfolded in a dark room. Like, I didn't have to do all that just to like a song. This song was just first listen. I'm not even in the mood to hear a Cole album. I'm trying to hear Migos. I'm about to go back to listen to Playboi Carti. I want to hear Mr. Rage, Trippie Redd. So I got to get into this vibe. And this still caught my attention. I said, this is hard. I ain't going to lie. This is hard. This became my favorite song on the album off the first listen. Now, after a few more listens, I think it's another song later down the line. But it's cool. This song is undeniable fire. I love it. Track number six is 100 Mil. This song actually grew on me after a few listens. The first thing I didn't like was him mumbling. The mumbling harmony, it sounded real nasty the first time I heard it. I picture how ugly a nigga look in the booth every time they harmonize and singing their soul out. I always think of that. I don't know. I think it's hilarious. But I just picture a nigga. Like, look how ugly I look. I look ugly. Mumbling my heart away. I'm not a singer. I can't sing, but I'm trying my hardest. Shut up. Get out the booth. I get what he was doing, though. He was trying to catch his flow. He was trying to get it right. He should have took that out, though. I ain't like that. But it's cool. I like the melody of it when he actually put the words to it, and I actually heard what he was saying. I thought it was cool. I like the beat. The beat was cool. It was like, I don't know. I want to say generic. Like, I heard a few people rap on beats like that. It's just a typical beat people would use. But seemed like something he would use. So it was alright. I rock with it though. Track number 7. Pride is the devil. You know, at first when I heard this, I wasn't really that pressed for it. Like, I was like, eh. Well, first of all, Lil Baby is featured on this. I didn't know that at first. The first time I listened to it, I didn't even know Lil Baby was on the record, which is cool. It was a surprise. This seemed like the one song that would have made the most sense to put Lil Baby on, like, production-wise. He could have put him on 100 mil, too, though. I feel like Baby would have killed that beat, too. But I feel like this made the most sense. This made the most sense. So I get it. I was happy he got a Lil Baby feature. I'm like, okay, stepping out your box. That's what I always said I wanted to see you do. So you did. You went and got Lil Baby and jumped on the track. I like that. That was dope. And you brought Lil Baby to your world. You didn't just go to a straight trap beat like he would do and then just try to get him on that. Nah, you kept it like with the theme of the album. You get what I'm saying? That's important for an artist to know how to do that. You got to know how to not always got to go to Lil Baby's lane and dumb yourself down thinking you got to meet Lil Baby halfway. Nah, you don't got to do that. You might have to hit you a little melody and flow, but the beat could be still with a nice sample like you always do, make it hard a little bit. You know, I think they sounded good together. It was cool. I think Lil Baby killed his verse. I feel like he didn't get washed by Cole. I think Cole didn't go as hard as he could have, but he was trying to focus on melody. He had some... Cole focused a lot. He focused on melody a lot, I noticed. But he also had some dope bars about pride. The way he flipped, like, different examples of pride kicking in and just being a horrible thing to have. I like that. I love how he did that with that verse. His verse was very dope on this. And then Baby's verse was dope, too. I think it's a dope song. The melody got stuck in my head, too. After a couple listens, I noticed I was paranoid. And I put you over everything. I don't even know all the words, but I like that melody a lot. So it got me. It got me. Track number 8, Let Go My Hand, featuring Boss and Black. I ain't gonna lie. This is officially my favorite song on the album. Let's hear a little bit.
The album is 7th grade and played it so much, you would have thought my favorite rapper was Puff. Back then, I ain't no shit. Now I know too much.
I love this song. I couldn't believe how amazing it was. And the first time I heard it, it's another one that it didn't take 30 listens to get me to understand it. It took 2 listens for me to go back and appreciate the lyrics. Because at first, I was just like, ooh, the way he flipped this beat, this little, I think it's a drum loop or whatever. I don't know if it's a drum loop or not. Maybe it's not a sample. But I know he sampled something in it. But the beat caught my attention. I was like, oh my God, this is that Cole. He needs to be on something like this. This is that Cole. That it felt like old Cole for some reason, like early career Cole. It felt like something he would have did in the past, like Friday Night Lights or something like that. I don't know. It just caught my attention. I was like, it feel nostalgic, and I can't explain why, but I love the beat, and I admired it for the first 2 listens. But then I went back and I listened to the lyrics. I said, oh my God, this is crazy, because he's talking about so much stuff. Like, this is the most, I want to say the most personal I feel like he got on the project. I rock with the song. Let's move on. So track number 9 was The Interlude. This is a song, he actually put this out a little bit, but like a couple days before the album dropped.
Put a hustle and making the best out of struggle. I kept grinding to the stay up a level. Respect mine, gotta stay out of trouble. Cause Tech Nine's like the air I rebuttal.
I ain't gonna lie, this song hard. And I'm glad, you know, I didn't even listen to The Interlude prior to the album. I know he dropped it a few days before the project, but I ain't even listen to it. I said, I'm gonna just wait till the album drop. I wanna hear it in the sequence of the album. To make it make sense. I don't like, you know, certain artists, you don't do that with them. Like, it's not just a single or nothing like that. It says interlude. That means it could be the calm before the storm of the next song if you flow it into the album. You get what I'm saying? It was a dope song. I like the sample flip. I like the melody he was using when he was spitting. It's rare that people could use melody and still use lyrics, lyricism. Like, it's hard to do that. It is hard to flow, catch a flow. Because a lot of rappers, they catch a flow, but they don't got to say nothing. Like, they don't say nothing. And they don't say nothing. And it just makes sense. It's like, ooh, he's killing it because of the flow. And then you hear a nigga like Cole come in, rap with that same flow, but he actually say something. You're like, no, he's killing it. The other dude was just mumbling. He wasn't saying much. That guy is actually putting a story together within the verse. That's different. How do you do that? Because it's hard to find words to flow into the melody. You got to find the right words, but you're still able to be like a lyricist in the flow. That's crazy. Track number 10 is The Climb Back. I can't stand this song. I'm not going to lie. I cannot stand it. This is something. I think he put this out as a two-pack. I can't think of the name of the other song. Snow on the Bluff? Was it Snow on the Bluff? I think that's it. Yeah, I ain't like neither of them like that. I ain't gonna cap. I ain't like neither of them. Didn't want to hear them again. The Climb Back. I didn't like this song when I heard it back then. It don't sound no better in the sequence of the album. I don't like the beat. I don't like the sample. The sample is very nasty. I think the sample, the way he did, how distorted it sounds, like the vocals, like it's pitched up too far or something. Like, I don't know. I don't like it. Don't like it at all. Track number 11 is Close.
Ride around with the toast and you keep that shit close. Cause niggas plotting on you since you chose to roll around with the candy paint on spokes. You know fear niggas don't like it when you boast. You know 12 be taking notes and they watching you close.
Yeah, I rock with this song. This reminded me of that Friday Night Lights Cove. Like, even he said Philmatic. Yeah. If you know, you know. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know. But, yeah, I rock with this song. I rock with this song because it sound like something that could have been on Friday Night Lights. I like the beat does, you know, the topic choice, all of that. I like it. I like where he's going with this. I like the storytelling. Track number 12 is Hunger on Hillside.
These words I still sing like I'm slept on. I sin so I can't cast the next stone. Unless it's baguettes round my neck bone. Power back. Ain't fucking around. Be even with me. Gonna get you hollered at. Niggas can't see me one on one. That's where the collar bread. You hitting them weights. Congratulations. Cause you built some.
I rock with the song. It wasn't my favorite or nothing. It wasn't like a standout joint, but I thought it was a cool closing to the album. It sounded a little triumphant. It got the, I don't know, certain sounds in it that I like. Like, when I think about the intro and then compare it to the outro, yeah, they make sense to me. I see why the intro is the intro. I see why the outro is the outro. I rock with it. So, with that being said, how I feel about the project so far, I think it's a good project. Like I said, I already went into it with no expectations. I was like, I don't know, man. He ain't really been putting out nothing that I think is top level quality wise, you know. This one is definitely a step up though, I'm not gonna lie. This one might have it's definitely gonna have more replay value than For Your Eyes Only, for sure. It's definitely gonna have more replay value than KOD. For sure. There's a few songs on here already that I'm like, I'm definitely gonna listen to this more than anything on KOD. So that's a step up. But I put it, if I'm ranking all his albums right now, I put it right above KOD. KOD is my second least favorite. And at the bottom of the bottom is For Your Eyes Only for me. But I put at in the third spot, I'm gonna put this album. Because there's other albums I feel is better than this. I do not feel it's better than 2014 Forest Hills Drive. I do not. I feel like that album, the first time I listened to it, I knew it. I was like, man, this is just amazing. I was mind blown. This didn't blow my mind. I was not mind blown. I was not taken back like, how did he think of that? It was just, all right, rapping good. Okay, cool. But he did what I always said I wanted him to do. He used different producers. He did that. Cool. I don't think using different producers really helped that much, though. I don't think he really stepped outside of a box that he's already in. I think he's still in the same box. Like, when I say go get Timbaland and get Pharrell and get Boy Wonder and get all of these other people, when I say go call them, I don't mean ask them to make beats that you would have made for yourself anyway. Cole could have just made these beats himself. He could have just made every beat on here himself. Like, what did they do that you couldn't have did yourself? Like, what pushed you to the next level. Like, yo, I ain't never had no beat like this. I'm gonna try it though. You know, like, what did you really do production-wise? That's something that sound like, you know what I mean? Like, and I get it. When you talk to a producer, they kind of try to make something that sound like something you would be on. I get that. But I wanted Cole on something that's, I don't even know how to explain it. Give him a club banger. Give him a love song. Give him a, you know, you need to, and when I say love song, I don't mean like folding clothes. The song Fold Club? No, hell no. That not a simp record. Not even a simp record because he's married. Not like that. I'm just not nothing dumb like that though. I'm talking about like a real love song. Like, get you an R&B singer. Get you somebody who can bring something to life for you. You know what I mean? Like, I can't explain. It's just certain things. Like, I want producers to bring more out of him. Like, don't keep giving him the beats he always been doing for the last 3 to 4 albums that we keep saying ain't that good. Like, okay, they cool, but what about it? This is one of the ones that fall into the category of like, okay, but what's so different about this? But I can tell you where was a step up. Middle Child. Middle Child is a prime example of a step up. The beat knocks is hard. It's something I never heard him on, nothing like that. And he pushed himself to a new level. Like, okay, how can I get on a beat like this, huh? Yeah, okay, cool. He caught a flow. He was killing it. That's what I'm talking about. Even with the features, he didn't really step too far outside his box. He already worked with 21 Savage. Safe. Black. I can see you working with Black. Okay, he do the same music, but you did a song with him before. Safe. Boss, he's signed to you. Y'all got a million songs together. Safe. Who else is on here? Moray. Okay, he's singing a little bit on the hook. Cool. He don't need to be getting features from people who ain't as lyrically nice as him. He don't even need to worry about that no more. Stop doing that. That ain't pushing you, because you just start having fun with flows and stuff. If you want to push Cole to the next level lyrically, call Kendrick. Call Drake. Even get you Big Crit, Wale. Go back to them dudes, the ones who was the essence of, like, when Cole was coming up, these guys was coming up with him. Do a song with Wale. Get you a love song with some poetry from Wale, and let's see you get poetic. Meet him halfway. Can you beat him on the poetic tip? Nah, let's see. Push yourself though. Drake, he's a king of the hooks and the hits. Call him, tell him to do the hook. And then tell him get as lyrical as he can, like y'all did on that one song on that Jodeci freestyle. Tell him push you, which I don't know what you was thinking. That song, Drake washed Cole on that Jodeci freestyle. Washed him on that joint. You should have came more prepared. Don't ever let that happen again. Get your get back though. It's time to get your get back. Do like Cole did when he was on that song with Good Music. What's that joint? Trouble? Looking for Trouble? When Pusha T went, then Kanye went. Get all the GOATs. He had the GOATs, the top lyricists in the game rapping. Cole said, hell no, I'm not getting outdone. Pushed his ass to a level so far, they cut the beat off at the end and just looked at Cole. I know they had to just be staring like, is this nigga serious, dog? Like, should we take his verse off, right? Yeah, we want them verses. Push that nigga. Call Kanye. Get cool with him again. Tell him flip you a sample. You love rapping on all his beats before. Tell Kanye I need one of them old beats. But I started to say we need Cole to compete. Push it to the next level. This ain't next level. This is just cool. This just fall into the normal catalog stuff he always do. And I ain't hear nothing on here that was mind-blowing or on the next level. So that, with that being said, if I had to rate the album, I would give this joint, I give it a 7 out of 10, man. 7 out of 10. Yeah, y'all comment below. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all comment your favorite songs on the album. Did you like the album? What do you rate it? Because do you agree with my 7 out of 10? Or nah? No? Yeah? No? Higher? Lower? Let me know. What else? Yeah, like, hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video. Hit the thumbs down if you didn't. It don't make no difference to me. Subscribe if you didn't already. Follow me on IG, all that good stuff. The links is all down below. All that. You know what I'm saying? It's your boy, Nair Mar. I'm out. Peace.